Shang-Chi could suffer because Marvel can't push pause on its big story. Shang-Chi is a legend, as are the 8 films that follow it. For a variety of reasons, Shang-Chi and the Legend of the Ten Rings is a pivotal film for Marvel. It's the studio's first return to theatrical exclusivity after more than a year and a half of delays due to COVID-19, which included shifting Black Widow to Disney Plus as well as theaters. Shang-Chi, on the other hand, highlights the MCU's core issue: its films and series are too linked for Marvel to alter or delay their release dates, which corresponds with reduced theater attendance as the Delta variant continues to climb in the United States. Marvel films, on the other hand, confront a unique challenge. Not only do they have to avoid clashing with other major studio releases across Disney's schedule, but they also have to strike a delicate balance between theatrical and streaming Marvel releases. Shang-Chi has to be released in theaters. It can't use it to, quickly, push Disney Plus subscriptions or collect more data on hybrid releases, and it'll almost probably take a hit at the box office just to keep up with the competition. Take a look at what we know so far about Marvel's planned films and TV shows. Due to the fact that Hawkeye will launch on Disney Plus in November, Black Widow must be released first. Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness must come before Spider-Man, No Way Home, and it has the added complexity of being released by Sony rather than Marvel, which might throw Marvel's next wave of films into disarray if Sony delays it. That's not even taking into consideration reports that Black Panther, Wakanda Forever will tie into the next Ironheart series, or any plans for a fourth Captain America feature starring Anthony Mackie's Sam Wilson, which could impact future Disney Plus shows. The Disney Plus shows are delayed because they must wait for the movies, which are the big moneymakers and must be released in theaters, but Marvel can't afford to delay the Disney Plus shows because they are one of the biggest draws for keeping paying subscribers to the service, which is becoming an increasingly important part of its business strategy. While box office billions are great, the company must also consider how to keep Disney Plus releases consistent. Hawkeye is set to premiere in November, while the current Marvel series concludes in October. Since MCU shows began running on Disney Plus in May 2020, there has only been 1 month in which there hasn't been at least one new episode of a Marvel show on the service, a streak that the company appears to be extending until the end of 2021 and beyond. Do you release films early in order to lose some box office revenue? Alternatively, you might put things off and offer subscribers the option of skipping a few months of Disney Plus in the hopes of a greater box office stake in a more traditional theater setting. If Disney believes Shang numbers cheese don't add up, Eternals may be relegated to a hybrid release or a streaming-only release via Premier Access. One of the MCU's most valuable features has been its interwoven storytelling, which employs a comic book-style manner to make every chapter a must-see, just as each issue in a long-running series is to getting the whole plot. In the complex web of streaming, theatrical releases, and ever-shifting release dates of 2021, however, that interrelated nature is quickly becoming an issue that even the most popular heroes can solve.